So what if you do an interview of some person that don't want their voice to be heard on YouTube or wherever platform, and they don't want their face to be seen? What you can do is to simply blur and
change the voice of that person to make it unrecognizable. And you can simply make this effect in Lumafusion
and save it as a preset. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another exciting Lumafusion tutorial. In this tutorial, we're gonna create this deep voice effect using some audio effects. And this is kind of putting us on the track where we will be doing some audio adjustments as well and going a little bit deeper into the audio part of Lumafusion. And if you want to learn more about audio and how you can adjust the specific things to increase your sharpness of your voice, to decrease some of the noise in your voice as well, or the background noise like this denoise effect and some other things, you might want to sign up for a Lumafusion Masterclass. And if you're already a member of Lumafusion Masterclass, you will get 38 audio enhancement presets. Some of them are made for really low audio. So if you have really low audio, like whisper audio, you can boost that up so you can actually hear the voice. And the same goes with high voice as well. If you're talking very high, you can bring that down with some of the presets, make the voice sharper, and also have some denoise inside the audio. But keep in mind that denoise is very tricky when it comes to Lumafusion, since you don't actually have any specific denoise presets to add, but you can work around to get some sort of a denoise effect to your audio. So make sure to join in on Lumafusion Masterclass, or wait until those presets will pop up on Selfie. So once we have Lumafusion open, the first thing we're going to do is to import our video clip with audio attached. You can also import your audio file only, but we're going to use audio and video at the same time. So what we can do is to simply cut this clip here, delete this first one, and we can go to the beginning again and we can cut out another part. Delete the last part, and here we have our audio and video file. So what I like to do is to tap on the video file and detach the audio. And then we're gonna make sure that we have selected the audio file, and then go over to the pencil tool on the bottom section here. Tap on the pencil and go over to audio on the bottom right here. And once we're inside audio, we're gonna go over to pitch. So in this tutorial, we're gonna make a deep voice, and it's as simple as this. So we're gonna increase the audio so we can hear the voice. Just a little bit more like that. We're gonna go to the beginning and we're gonna do a playback.
Capture in this video, so it's gonna be super awesome to create this.
So there we have the normal audio. Once we take the pitch scale and lower that to, let's say, -650. If we now do a playback of the same audio file, you will now hear that the voice sounds different. So there we have the deep voice. We can also lower this to, let's say, -1000. And we can do another playback. We can increase the volume a little bit. And another thing that you can do to make the dark or the deep voice sound a little bit clearer is to take the overlap down to 3, which is the lowest. If we now do a playback, you can still hear that you have the deep voice, but the voice sounds a little bit clearer. We can do another example as well. So we can use the same video file, maybe. Let's see if we can find some other parts here.
which is really awesome with this iPhone 11 is that you have this wide angle.
So we can stop it there. We can take this and drag it down to our timeline. Detach the audio and go into edit on the audio file only. Go over to audio and then down to pitch. And change the pitch scale to, let's say around 700-800 this time. And we can take the overlap down to 3. And we can now uncheck this so we can hear the normal voice without any adjustments.
So another thing which is really awesome with this iPhone 11 is that you have this wide angle.
So now that was the normal voice. If we go back to the beginning and check this again, you can hear now that we have the deep voice applied.
So another thing which is really awesome with this iPhone 11 is that you have this wide angle.
And let's say you have made the perfect settings for your audio file or for your audio, which you are recording on your microphone, on your iPhone or whatever. You can simply add this as a preset. The only thing you do is go over to the star here with the plus inside, tap on the star, choose your desired name. Let's say audio 1111. Tap on the star on the top right corner here one more time, and it's now saved. So if we delete this, we can go over to the star and you can choose audio 1111 here. And you have now applied the preset to your clip.
Another thing which is really awesome with this iPhone 11 is that you have...
So with that said, that's how super easy it is to make this cool effect, which you can use on your own voice or if you make some wines or whatever you are making on your iPad with Lumafusion. And also it's super simple to save them as a preset, so make sure to adjust some settings and save them as your own preset. And that will also speed up your workflows because you can simply just go to the star and apply the effect and voila, you're done. So with that said, I hope you learned something new from this video. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe, smash that notification bell, and give this video a big thumbs up. Make sure to share it if you found any value in this video. And until next time, make sure to create some awesome stuff in Lumafusion, and I see you in the next video. Peace. Yeah, I paid my dues to show you I'm not the same. It has cost me much, but I would